Well, if you eat fresh sprouts, they're fine. If you, oh, you mentioned that you freeze broccoli.
I wanted to ask you about that.
So when you freeze them, as this is interesting, you freeze them, you take them out of the freezer. If you put them in a blender and make a smoothie right away, then the myrosinase is going to act in that liquid, mm-hmm. right?
Right.
And so you're going to be getting plenty of sulforaphane, I think. If you let those sprouts thaw out, there's a bunch of juice that's going to run out. They're going to look like a slimy mess, right? Mm-hmm. So by the time you see that juice and either pour it off or pour it in your container, probably most of the myrosinase activity has occurred, and sulforaphane has probably started to bind to proteins and macromolecules in that vegetable mess. And because what happens is when you freeze the plant tissue, when you thaw the plant tissue, I guess, you've broken down all the cell, many of the cells. So the lignin, the structure in the outside of the plant cells is still there, but the cells are trashed.
Oh, is that why freezing increases sulfur and it's just breaking?
Well, ice crystals are forming. It releases the enzyme, allows the enzyme and the substrate to come into contact, form sulforaphane. It's probably okay, but you have to capture all the juice, or the easiest thing is just throw it in the blender right away, what you do. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But it's interesting because friends in industry, and in fact, we were wrestling with this. We have a freeze dryer. We have a beautiful freeze dryer that we were actually given by a Japanese sprout company as sort of thanks for what we've done. We've allowed them to build a business in broccoli sprouts. And this freeze dryer has trays, and it, you know, you can put, say, 5 pounds of sprouts on the trays. So, but what you have to do is you have to freeze the sprouts first and then put them in the freeze dryer, pull a vacuum, and it winds up pulling off all the moisture. If you stick the trays in a freezer and freeze them and then move them into the freeze dryer, basically what you've done is allowed all the cells to break. They thaw as you're pulling a vacuum. And when we looked at those freeze-dried sprouts, they had no glucoraphanin and no myrosinase and no sulforaphane to speak of, because it had all reacted, and then, you know, it was just a mess. So there's value in thinking a little bit about how that enzyme behaves before you start making things. You can actually freeze dry broccoli sprouts very nicely as long as you deep freeze them or quick freeze them and maintain them in the frozen state when you go to dry them.
And that will retain the
Myrosinase. The myrosinase is not coming in contact with the glucosinolate then.
Okay.